Holy crap, guys, tonight we are in Astoria, Oregon, where behind me lies the remains of One-Eyed Willie's ship. One-Eyed Willie and the rich stuff is long gone, but tonight we're going on a crazy Goonie adventure to find it. I cannot believe that I am here in Goonies Town. I have seen so many of the locations as I'm driving around just to get to the first one, which is right in front of me. Guys, I have been obsessed with the Goonies since I was about 8 years old. We used to have to rent a VCR from a local video shop, and every time my dad would say that we could get a video that we loved, every time I got the Goonies. And there it is, right up ahead of me. Guys, I feel like I'm gonna have a heart attack. I'm gonna faint, I can't believe it. Holy crap, what happened? I'm good, okay, let's go. Halfway through the film, Mikey stops and says,
"It all starts here."
But the truth of the matter is, it all starts here. This is the county jail from the beginning of the movie where Jake escapes from that door right there, and Francis and Mama Fratelli are waiting right here in the ORV. And holy crap, speaking of, there it is. It even has the bullet holes,
the size of matzo balls.
Francis poured gas all around the perimeter, while Mama Fratelli sat right here and said,
"Come on!"
Jake came meandering out the door, and trying to get in the ORV, an argument ensued.
"I don't have the handle, open the lock!"
"Jake, up!"
Jake jumps in the sunroof, Francis shoots the line of gas, igniting the fire, and Mama Fratelli peels out this way. She flies up the road while the building burns around this corner and up this street. And you can tell it's this street because you can see this blue building in the background as she flies up this way. Up this street and around this corner, and in the shot it's all leaves and shrubbery. But as they come up and around, you can see these two posts right here. And what do you know? Perfectly, a Jeep is coming up the street. They come from the jail, around that corner, past that building, fly around this corner, down this street, look at the windows on this house because it's going to play a part in a minute, down this street where there's a hot car on the corner by the stop sign. Notice this part of the building right here too. This didn't exist at the time. The muscle car was sitting right here, down the street, around the corner, past the hot car, and up 8th Street right here. Remember the two houses I pointed out up there? In this scene, you can see the windows on that house up there, as well as the door and the part of the wall that steps out there. In 1985, that building looked a little different. It had a couple windows on the side, and the door had a little awning over it. I can't stand it, guys. I have to drive the route. Mama Fratelli peels out right here, turns right and flies by the burning building, turns left past the blue roof building, up this hill, turns left again, and flies down by the hot muscle car. And turns right, eluding the police up this giant hill. Guys, look at this. Right in the middle of the Fratelli chase, there's a deer crossing the street. Hello, little guy. Be safe. Now, the next shot we see, and right before they get to Andy's field, they are flying down that hill. It's a low static shot, like from down here, where they fly over the hill and down. And the only place I can find a house that looks anything like the one in the background is right here, which is actually coming back down the hill that we just came up. That is a pretty cool looking house, though, so I wouldn't doubt it if they just flipped the angle they were filming, just because it looks cool. A little less than a mile away is Columbia Memorial Hospital. Where I'm standing right now would have been the field where we first meet Andy with her cheerleading squad.
By the victory pyramid!
There were bleachers over here, there were bleachers over here. Andy and her squad was right over here, and you could see these three houses right in the background. And then right behind her, you can see the Fratellis drive by just like that truck right there on that road. I'm telling you guys, you can't come out here to see these locations and not be singing the whole Goonies soundtrack the whole time. The chase then leads us about 2 miles up the road to what I call Rosalita's coffee shop. Pedal to the metal, the Fratellis fly right past this coffee shop where Rosalita is standing in the middle of the road. The Fratellis on one side, the cops on the other. And Rosalita, in her cute little bonnet, right in the middle of the road, runs away saying... Bertelli's come zooming up this hill here and turn and fly down that street right there, directly across from Mouth's house. Whereas Dad's working on the plumbing inside the kitchen, and Mouth looks out that window right there and can see them flying down this street right here.
Turn that TV off, son. I can't hear myself think.
Yeah, right, Dad.
Okay, guys, our next location, I'm a little hazy on. On the internet, everybody says that it's right here where we meet Steph, where she's got her head in the big thing of water. She comes out, pushes her hair back, and tosses the crab. Now, this is the East Basin Causeway. As you can see, this is concrete down here. Due to structural issues, it is blocked off now. I cannot walk out there to look at anything else. The fence along the side looks correct. However, like I said, it's concrete. And looking back on Google Earth, it looks like it's been concrete all the way back to at least 1994, where you can see the aerial views. Plus, this just goes straight out there and tees off. And yes, those are seals that you hear back there interrupting me filming. They're so loud! But yeah, this just goes straight down and then it makes a T and there's boats out there. That's not really how it was shaped in the movie. So even though this is the popular opinion of that filming location for that scene, I kind of think it's a little farther up here on Pier 39. Holy crap, look at that sweet pirate ship. At least in my imagination. It's a pirate ship. This is Pier 39, and this looks so much more like what is in the movie. That's the causeway right over there, the concrete causeway. Now, they could have put concrete over those beams, but I highly doubt it. Because if you look back on Google Earth, this one has been beams the whole time. Plus, it opens up to this whole giant area here, where there would be so much more room for cameras and equipment and the big tank that Steph was sticking her head in. The tank would have been about right here. All the camera equipment would have fit right back here, filming in this direction. As the Fratellis and the cops zoomed across the causeway, and then it focused in on Steph as she pushed her hair back and threw the crab. There was even a payphone somewhere in the background back here, which would have made so much more sense than out on that one where it just comes out and tees off. Yes, the railing is different from the other one over there and what we see in the movie, but that could have been replaced. That just seems to make a lot more sense along with everything else on this pier that fits that scene than over on the other one. Oh, this looks like one of the space pods from Cocoon. I don't know, you guys do some research and you tell me what you think. But I personally think this is the spot right here. Looking at this ghost ship makes me think of the interviews with the kids where they said that they didn't get to see Willy's Inferno until they came out of the slides into the water. Holy crap, that would have been so awesome. Look at this ginormous boat here, the Pilot Peacock. I've driven by this thing about 10 times today looking for these locations, so I had to stop and take a look. Not only is there a boat, but there's an enormous anchor in front of it. And I'll tell you why that's significant over here, away from the loud traffic. Look at this barge out here. It always amazes me how a big piece of iron and steel can float. Anyway, so what I was saying is, the reason that that anchor is significant right now is because I am stuck in one place trying to find the location where they introduced us to Data. In the process of researching these locations, you watch the scenes over and over, sometimes on super slow-mo, looking for the smallest amount of detail that you can grab onto and find it in the background somewhere. But everything in that scene where they introduce Data is rusty and falling apart and crumbling and corrugated aluminum and just crap that probably was cleaned up long ago. It could have even been filmed in a studio somewhere. You just never know. But I did spend at least an hour on Google Earth, and I've been driving around here for about 4 hours keeping it in mind, and I just can't find it. If anybody has any information about that location, let me know, because that is the one during the Fratelli chase that I did not find. Oh, Holy crap, guys, the next location is one of my absolute favorites. The Fratellis come zooming down this road right here, around this corner, and Chunk is standing right inside these windows here. When he notices the police chase, runs up and smashes his pizza and milkshake right on the window, and the Fratellis zoom right past down that street. Oh my gosh, look at this, guys.
Oh wow, a police chase!
Look at this. Hey Goonies treasure hunters, here's your clue. What is Chunk's first name? I swear, guys, it's right on the tip of my tongue, and I can't think of what it is. You guys tell me in the comments below. After the Fratellis fly by Chunk's bowling alley, they come down this street right here, right past this building here, right down here on this side where they stop. You can see this on the side. You can see this restaurant up here. They come to a stop right here, and Jake says,
"What the hell are we doing here?"
They pull onto the beach this way where you see Haystack Rock in the ORV race with hundreds of trucks. Guys, if I said I was excited before, I was crazy. Look at that thing. It is beautiful. It is absolutely enormous. You can even tell how big it is from right here on film. It is huge!
Throwing the four-wheel drive and hold on to your hat!
Right here is where the stand would have been that said third annual ORV race. Trucks, Jeeps, SUVs, 4x4s, as far as the eye can see. And they all ensued in a race along Cannon Beach. After the Fratellis elude the police, we cut to a scene of Mikey hanging out his bedroom window, talking to Brand about how he can't wait to get out of the Goondocks. This is that window, and this is the house. Yes, guys, we are at the actual Goonies house, the Walsh house. Now, let me just say, depending on what's going on at any given time, there may be a sign out here that says you cannot walk up to the house. I cannot stress enough, if you come to visit the Goonies house, respect those signs and the owner of the house. Most fans are awesome, but there have actually been people who have come up here and stolen parts of the house and thrown trash around and caused all kinds of problems, guys. So respect the owners. I'm so excited, I can't even place anything here. So much hilarity ensued at this house. And right beside is Data's house. It looks totally different, but that's where he ziplined across to this house and broke through the front door. Right over here is where Chunk would have done the truffle shuffle. In the living room is where Chunk would have broken the statue and glued the wiener on upside down. And right here is where Brand would have stole Data's little sister's bike. And she would have said, "I want my bike! I want my bike!" All right, guys, take it in one last time. Because at this point, the guys all jump on their bikes and head down this driveway out to our next location. They jump on their bikes, ride down the driveway. Mom and Rosalie come home and find Brand tied up. And 2 seconds later, the boys are passing the museum right here on 8th Street, right by the jail. They ride their bikes out of this street, in front of the museum, and down this street. As they ride by, they wave at Mikey's dad, who's standing right there putting up the flag. This museum is actually 2 miles from the Walsh house. And it's funny because at this point, we've made a complete circle, because here is the county jail where the Fratelli chase started this morning. And there is the path they took around the back of the museum, out Exchange Street and up that hill. Pretty cool. These are the roads to Ecola Park, these winding, twisting roads. And somewhere around here, like probably around this bend here, because it looks very familiar, is where the kids were riding their bikes and we were getting an aerial shot. Right around this bend here is where they would have pulled over their bikes and dropped them and looked out over the water and the rocks. And Chunk said, "Does anybody got a Baby Ruth?" Even though somehow he came up with a Baby Ruth later to give to Sloth. So the Goonies are riding their bikes. They leave the house, they roll through town, they pass the museum, and within seconds, they're over here by Cannon Beach. This exact location right here is where they're hauling their bikes up over the hill. Guys, seriously for a minute here, look how absolutely beautiful that is out there. That is absolutely amazing. And just looking at that right there, knowing that that is straight out of the Goonies absolutely blows me away. Makes me want to throw on a raincoat and jump on my BMX. All right, guys, so let's keep going here. Now, the thing on the internet right now, everybody is saying that this little building over here was put up in place of the restaurant. That is completely 100% not true. The first time I saw that, I thought, no way. It's right here. The background does not match up whatsoever. Holy crap, guys. Look at this. I almost completely missed this. These are elk on the side of the hills over here. What in the world? Oh my gosh, we certainly didn't see any of those in the Goonies. However, down this trail here, the way that I just came, this is the place I just showed you where they were pulling their bikes up over the hill. Up over here and around the bend, over there is where the restaurant was. Now this is a pretty hilly area here, but you gotta find different landmarks to find these filming locations. And look at this spooky tree right here. Without even pulling up the footage, I recognize this tree, guys. The kids go down through here, and there used to be a branch sticking out, and I believe that the scene goes up, and you can see the Lighthouse Lounge in the background. Of course, there's all these trees here now. Plus, it was only built for the movie. So they've already torn it down right after they filmed the movie. But you can see it in the distance there. You can see this tree right here with a branch sticking out. The Lighthouse Lounge was right over there, and then there were some rocks in the distance there that you also can't see right now because of those trees. Not only that, but it's the spookiest tree I've ever seen in my life. It reminds me of the tree in Poltergeist. Another thing that cracks me up about the scene is that when Mikey is holding the doubloon and he says,
"The lighthouse, the rock, and the restaurant all fit the doubloon."
That doesn't make sense because the rock, the other rock, and the lighthouse match up, but not the rock, the lighthouse, and the restaurant. Okay, so I've been following this trail, but I believe I have to go up here to where the restaurant was. So let's traipse up through this high grass here and try not to get bit by a snake. Okay, yeah, definitely. This is much more like the background that goes with the restaurant. I know the sun is in our eyes right here, but the restaurant would have definitely been like right over here in this area. Yep, those are the rocks in the background where the kids would have skipped by right here and stopped at that big piece of machinery right in front of the restaurant, which would have been smack dab in the middle of that. So guys, I'm standing where they would have been standing inside the restaurant, just inside the door where Mama Fratelli would have said,
"The only thing we serve is tongue.
No.
You boys like tongue?"
So being that this restaurant was built for the movie and then torn down right after they wrapped production, there obviously was no basement here. Therefore, there was no tunnels under here. There was no sloth. There was no stiff. There wasn't even any Rocky Road ice cream.
Rocky Road?
All of that would have been filmed on sound stages in Hollywood. Our next scene brings us to the Astoria Country Club. This place actually exists. Although it is actually called the Astoria Golf and Country Club, and I am not sure anything was actually filmed here. I know one thing it definitely was not. When they're underground beating on the pipes and the guys are playing tennis, they come out to get a drink and the water fountain starts going up and down. That was not even filmed here. They don't even have tennis courts. It's actually right here, about 10 miles away from the country club and about 20 yards from Rosalita's coffee shop. But I'm not quite sure I agree with this. IMDb says that this is a spot right here off Leif Erikson Drive, and it could very well be, but there's a couple of things that don't really match up. First of all, there's no gate between the two courts on either side. Second, there's no evidence that there was ever a gate put in here or taken out. The courts appear to be much wider, as well as the nets. Now, they could have been changed, but there's no evidence that they were ever changed. And the drinking fountain was on flat ground right outside the fence. So it couldn't have been that way because there's a hill over there. It would have had to have been on this side here. What is this? I don't think that would have been the site of a drinking fountain. I mean, I'm sure the drinking fountain itself was just a prop, but there still would have been a door in the gate right there. Now, if by chance there was a door in the gate there originally, this spot over here is in about the right position where the drinking fountain would have been, and it would make sense that they would have gone down in there, stuck the drinking fountain up here so they could take it up and down. But I don't know. That's just me kind of trying to make the scene work. So if you guys know, let me know, because I'm very, very curious. So that brings us to our next location, and in looking at these, it makes me think of the Moss Garden Wishing Well. Even though that wishing well is supposed to exist at the country club, it doesn't. So it was more than likely filmed in California on a soundstage, unfortunately.
Andy! You goody!
Now, after they enter the fireplace into the tunnels of One-Eyed Willie, all of that stuff was filmed on sound stages. Everything from the bats, playing the bones, Chester Copperpot, the copper bones, the slides, One-Eyed Willie's ship, getting chased by the Fratellis, getting caught by the Fratellis, and escaping the Fratellis to right here on Cannon Beach. But with Hollywood, there's always a twist. Even though that scene takes place here on Cannon Beach, it wasn't filmed here on Cannon Beach. It was actually filmed on Goat Rock Beach in Jenner, California. What the heck? Look at these waves, guys. We are legit here in California. We made the trek almost 800 miles across the U.S. Okay, across Oregon and California to do this right and get the final scene of the Goonies exactly where it was filmed. Look at this, guys. There is such a heavy fog right now. You can't even see it. But those are the rocks over there. We are going right over there right now to show you the actual location of the final scene of the Goonies. Holy living crap, guys. We are here. This is unbelievable. This was so well worth the drive to get this final shot. I cannot believe this. And for all of you who have been asking through the whole video if I went to the last Blockbuster in Oregon, yes. Here's the glasses. Oh my Lord, guys, I am just absolutely beside myself being out here. This is every bit as good as actually being in Astoria. Cause in the movie, we technically still are in Astoria. But what in the world is this? What are these onion looking things that are all over the place out here? Look at this. What? I'm not even gonna say what that looks like. But anyways, the reason we're here, guys, the Goonies! So as I've said several times in these videos, I love how Hollywood works, how they start a scene somewhere and they make it look like you're in the same place. So if you look at these rock formations right here, the giant rock and these two right here, right between those is where the guys come riding through on the four-wheelers and the camera follows them this way along the beach. And look at this. This is where they rolled into the scene, but it didn't happen that way. That is pure Hollywood magic, because if you just follow the rest of the way over here, you can see you can't ride around that rock. And that beach that they end up on is clear on the other side over there. And what in the world is this? A tank on the beach? Is that like storming the beach at Normandy? Make sure you watch my Stand By Me video. There's the rock right there. There's the ginormous rock right there that I showed you couldn't drive around. And you can clearly see it down here. And if we keep going around, here's the beach they would have had to be on to film this way towards the split rock over here in order to complete that scene. So the scene where all the parents and the cops and the ambulance pull in, they all would have pulled in this drive right here. The ambulance would have been right here because you can kind of see that rock in the background. They all get out of the cars and they head down this way to that beach. Now the only building you can see here is a bathroom right up there. There was another building which was probably just like a production trailer or something, but I think it would have been right over here because you can see that in the background as they're going down to the beach. And holy crap, guys, here it is, the exact location right here where the guys on the four-wheelers drove right into the scene. But where it began was clear back down there. You can't even see it because of the fog. I had to walk so far to get down here and find this point. You can see every one of these rocks in the picture, including this one over here that looks like a monster with a big mouth. You can see this one here that looks like a lizard coming out. The split rock over here. This one over here that's like pointing out to sea. I am so absolutely blown away being here right now, guys. This is amazing. Is this not the greatest Goonies video ever? Okay, let me get a hold of myself. Look at these amazing waves back here, guys. This is absolutely crazy. So anyway, the guys on the four-wheelers drive up about right here. We see them pull into the scene right here where they say something about there's the goobers.
Them goobers.
And then it shows the Goonies all coming into view as a silhouette. We gotta go a little farther down the beach for that part. As the rock formations change just a little bit, you can still see the pointy one on the side there, but some of the other rock formations change in the background. And it's so foggy out here right now, we're gonna have to wait for that to lift before we can see into the background there. But meanwhile, look at these crazy waves. This is so cool. The tide is kind of up here, but I wanna go out and touch these Goonie rocks. All right, hold on here. So, I don't wanna get sucked out. Oh my God, guys, I wish every one of you could be out here with me right now. I'm having so much fun touching the Goonie rocks. Here's one we don't have to risk our life to touch. I just had to climb up on a couple of other rocks here. That's the one that you see in the background when the Goonies are coming out from between here. We're touching the Goonie rock! Oh my gosh, guys, my feet are so torn up climbing up these rocks here. They're so absolutely sharp. Look, I'm so jealous, guys. There is a guy who climbed up on one of the Goonie rocks down there. Okay, guys, so this is not clearing up, and I gotta step down here where these waves are coming to get this shot, so hold on. All right, I gotta be able to go down and about there to get the right angle of where the Goonies were coming out. The waves are just too big and the tide is on its way in, so I'm not gonna be able to get the exact angle. Look at this. It's like trying to swallow me up. But I'm gonna come down here and show you at least two of the rocks we can see, because that fog is not letting up, guys. So I showed you this one already. In the scene where the Goonies are coming out, you can see it right on the edge like that. The other one is this one right here. If you look right here with the light in the background, you can see that little hook. You can see that in the picture, but you can't see that big rock there because they got the shot from down there in the water, obviously when the tide was down. All right, here we go. It's a little something more like this. If I zoom in, you can see a little bit more of what it looked like. All right, guys, well, we're gonna keep moving on, get to the next scene here. I've been out here for probably an hour or more trying to get that shot out there, touching Goonie rocks. So let's move on up a little bit. Okay, we're way back up the beach now. Right here is where you can see the Fratellis coming up. You can see that rock in the background over there and the curve of the beach going around. And just in time, the fog is lifting, guys. So we're gonna be able to see the rocks that were in the background when One-Eyed Willie's ship floated out to sea. And guys, believe it or not, out of all these rocks on this beach, I have found the rock that the Goonies were sitting on when they were watching One-Eyed Willie's ship float away. This is the exact rock right here, guys, the exact spot. Everything matches up. This little nook on the rock, this one over here, all the striations in the rock going this direction, the background, everything matches up perfect. Right here is where they were all sitting and cheering on One-Eyed Willie's ship as it floated out to sea. Holy crap. I cannot believe that I found that rock. This seals this video so perfectly. I know it's a little foggy, guys, but you can still see it. This is the exact location they were filming from when One-Eyed Willie's ship came floating out between that rock and that one over there with the hole in it. All right, guys, to finish this off, I'm gonna show you the exact location where you can come to see the exact Goonies rock they were sitting on at the end of the movie if you come out here to Goat Rock Beach. When you come out here, the GPS will take you to a split in the road. It wants you to turn right and go to a lower parking lot, but you're gonna turn left and come up here where you can see that giant rock. Pull in this parking lot, you'll see the bathroom right there. And as we come over this way, you see the disabled parking. Walk straight down this line here towards these cones. And I get it, the cones might not still be here, but these parking spaces will. Just follow this line straight over here, go to the right, and you'll see a split between these two rocks right here where you can walk down. This is the Goonies rock right here. If you walk straight towards it, you can see these two big black rocks in the background right on the beach. There are no others before it and no others behind it. So if you're looking at those, back up and you'll see the Goonies rock right here. So that is it, guys. That is the Goonies locations, the most epic Goonies locations ever. We are going home to have some Domino's and Baby Ruth. We will see you guys next Saturday.